విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఃఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ టు. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత 29th వర్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ 4th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవాన్ వాచ అపానే జుహ్వతి ప్రాణం ప్రాణేపానం తథా పరే ప్రాణాపానగతిరుద్ధ్వా ప్రాణాయామ పరాయణాః. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ హ్యాస్ ఎన్యూమరేటెడ్ 10 యజ్ఞాస్ ఆల్రెడీ. హీ బిగన్ విత్ బ్రహ్మజ్ఞాన యజ్ఞ, దెన్ దైవ యజ్ఞ, దెన్ థర్డ్ వన్ వాస్ ఇంద్రియ నిగ్రహ యజ్ఞ, దెన్ విషయ గ్రహణ యజ్ఞ, ఆత్మ సంయమ యజ్ఞ. Then in the last words, he introduced 5 more: Dravya Yajna, Tapo Yajna, Yoga Yajna, Swadhyaya Yajna, Jnana Yajna. There are 10 Yajnas have been introduced already. Now here he wants to introduce Pranayama Yajna. Prana means vital force, energy, but in Upanishad it is said as Ishvara in so many places. Prana means Vayu Visheshaha. That is the general meaning. Vayu Vishesha means that which is related to Vayu. And this prana is considered as a life. If anybody dies, we say that pranan chala gaya. Pranan poindi. Pranan poindi. This is what we call it. Prana is the life. In order to save the energy, energy also sometimes known as prana. Prana is the energy. Prana is the vital nourishment force. Prana is Vayu, connected with the Vayu. Because when we were in the embryo, in the mother's womb, our lungs were not functioning. It means we were not having individual prana system. We were endowed with our mother's prana system. Because our body contains 5 kinds of pranas, this nature also has the 5 kinds of pranas. We call it prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. When you do Gayatri, ఓం భూర్భువః స్వః తత్ సవితృవరేణ్యం భర్గో దేవస్య ధీమహి ధియో యో నః ప్రచోదయాత్. సో దిస్ ఓం భూర్భువః స్వః, సో వైల్ సేయింగ్ దాట్ యు హావ్ టు ఇన్హేల్ ద ఎయిర్ ఓం భూర్భువః స్వః తత్ సవితృవరేణ్యం భర్గో దేవస్య ధీమహి ధియో యో నః ప్రచోదయాత్. ఇట్స్ లైక్ ఎ సర్కిల్. ప్రాణాయామ మీన్స్ వాట్? రేచక పూరక కుంభక. రేచక మీన్స్ వాట్? To exhale. Purakam, to inhale. Kumbhaka means to store inside, known as antara kumbhaka. When you keep the kumbhaka outside, when you stop your prana after letting the breath out, known as bahya kumbhaka. Our rishis have found this prana, vayu, which is connected with our life, our prana, and which is also connected with all the functions of our body. Karmendriyas, Jnanendriyas, mind and intellect, everything is connected with this Vayu Vicheshaha. And there are 5 kinds of Vayu, which we have already seen in the second chapter, but even though I am letting again to know. So this Udana, let me begin from the Udana. Udana is the Vayu where the center point is throat. This is the place for Udana, so which takes care about the force which is pushed towards up. we will use the word force. There are five kinds of force. A force which pushes towards up. So by which we get burp, vomiting, yawning, and finally also the life is taken through this udana alone. There is a vayu called Dhananjaya which takes us from this body and we leave the body through that Dhananjaya vayu. Apana is the place of nabi. That is the center place, that which takes care about this pushing towards down energy. Because of that energy, this all excreta are cleansed. Body is cleansed by that kidney, large intestine, urinal bladder, and all these are, you know, cleansed by this apana vayu. The apana vayu, also we call it gas, is the apana vayu. Not only gas, all the excretas which are, you know, taken away from the body is called apana vayu. If apana vayu is distracted, immediately we'll get the problem of constipation. Therefore, Ayurveda first it nourishes apana vayu, because Ayurveda considers the disease is because of imbalance of these five vayus. When udana is not working properly, so you won't get the burp, the air won't go outside. And the next one we call it samana. Samana is the place which takes care of digestion. This samana vayu, also known as Vaishvanaraha Jatharagni, being situated in the stomach, it takes care of the digestion which is, you know, important in our body. Ayurveda considers this place is the pradhana, important part of the body. This becomes secondary. The brain becomes secondary, but allopathy says brain is the control point, but the stomach is the stomach and the heart and lungs and liver, pancreas, gallbladder, this large intestine, small intestine, these are all the main functionary organs in our body. That's what the message from Ayurveda. Ayurveda says that these all 10 organs are functioned by the prana. You have to have a proper prana. Therefore, this prana must be balanced well. The next one is called vyana. Vyana means that which is pervaded all over the body. The center point is heart. Blood circulation is because of that. All the cells are rejuvenated because of that prana. Then finally, the prana which said as the prana, which is the place, the tip of the nose. That the tip of the nose is the place for that. You could see that Lord Shiva and Lord Buddha, so they are focused on that. This is the place where all the yogic technique begins with. So Rechaka Puraka. And this Rechaka Puraka is observed by meditators, because there is a very much connection between thoughts and pranayama. When you become angry, you can see, you can observe your the breath circulation, how it takes place. So now we have these five kinds of forces. These five kinds of forces must be balanced. If it gets distracted, the whole function is distracted. So these five kinds of pranas, which is in the form of vital energy, must be balanced. If they are distracted, body becomes ill. That is the understanding for our scriptures. Now, this pranayama, though this yogasana hits directly prana and it balances, but this pranayama, so without the help of the limbs, we use two fingers, just we directly organize our pranas. Yama means to control, to organize. Therefore, Yama Dharma, Lord Yama is known as Yama Dharma, because he doesn't worry for anything. He just strictly follows what to be followed for dharma. He doesn't have compassion. When a person's life must be plucked, he he will pluck immediately. He won't consider whether he got his daughter married or whether he is okay with his family, society. He never worries. He just performs. Even Patanjali also introduces the first sadhana is Yamaha. Yamaha means a proper discipline. Bringing discipline in your prana, in your breathing technique, in your all system is known as pranayama. This prana is the word which is given in different meaning in our Upanishads. In one place, prana even it is said as Ishvara. Prana means energy. Prana means life. Prana means everything. That prana which is used as the meditation. And there are two kinds of pranas are introduced in Vedas itself. Sagarbha, Nigarbha. Sagarbha means mantrena saha. You can do japa, veta, shwasa, praswasa. Even Patanjali says, shwasa praswasayor gati vichedaha pranayamaha. Gati means the flow of breath is reorganized by the technique called pranayama. So this person who does pranayama yajna, he is always endowed with his breath. He organizes his breath. So there are a certain group of people who follow Vasi Yoga. According to their norms, so the breath should not come out. They say that is anuloma and viloma. This inhalation and exhalation should be inside alone. We should not get connected with outside. Though lungs are connected with the outside, but they have the mentality, all the pranas are saved. Still the Vasi Yogam is followed in Kerala, I think in Vadakara, I think that place. And in Kutralam also it is followed Vasi Yoga. And there are many types of people, even Buddhist, you know, Vipassana. They call it Vipassana meditation. Just sit and observe. The breath comes in, the breath goes out. Like Lord Shiva, who is focused on the tip of the nose. You just sit. That is the easy way to bring your mind into control. When you just observed by your pranas, thoughts are reduced. And those techniques of in different way, just you focus on inhalation, puraka. You just forget about the exhalation and kumbhaka. Just you forget about it. Just focus on inhalation. Okay? Then just focus on exhalation. Then just focus on the kumbhaka. Then just focus on bahya kumbhaka. These are the techniques. Prani apanam juhvati. That's what you know. Prana pana gati rudhva. Gati rudhva means not disturbing, not stopping. So they say that rudhva means to stop, to restrain. But here by organizing. Apane pranam juhvati. Prane apanam juhvati. Actually, apana is the power which pushes towards down. They bring up. They bring up by concentrating on the tip of the nose. It's a highly technical way of introducing pranayama. We need to have a guru. Because apana which takes us to near the death. Okay. This, we call it, you know, this anus. The certain techniques, we have to pull the anus part, that is known as a kaya kalpa. Because that is the place, we call it mula dhara. That mula dhara is the place, it has to be risen the kundali. We call it kundali yogaha. Kundalini, not kundali, kundalini yogaha. Kundalini means the vital force which is existing in the human body. That force is coiled. That force can be risen with the help of this pranayama. So we should not allow the force to go towards down. We have to rise up. Therefore, people, usually you might have heard that rising kundalini. Even Lalita Sahasranam also introduces, but it should not be commercialized and it should not be practiced with the vague knowledge. We need to have complete knowledge, otherwise we should not practice. But I have seen the yogis who practice perfectly this pranayama technique. They will follow a different food, not idli, dosa, rice, chapati, dal, no. We take all kinds of food and doing pranayama, it won't help. You should not give complete food to the stomach when you follow pranayama. Especially that one yogi who I know very well, he used to have only cow's milk. So 2 glasses of milk per day, otherwise he won't take anything. That is the systematic way of this pranayama yajna. That also considered as the yajna alone. So this method, but we can follow a simple method. If you are affected by BP, blood pressure, just sit in a place or lie down on a floor. On a floor means on some mat, and relax yourself. You just observe the air goes out and the air goes in. Okay, just you focus, you keep your mind on tip of the nose, just feel the sensation of air comes in, goes out, but don't control. And slowly you can focus on exhalation, then inhalation, and kumbhaka and bahya kumbhaka. So these are advanced techniques, but you can just relax yourself with the breath. Okay, and you might have noticed a person when he sleeps, so his lungs are having tiny movement, small length of the breath. And many people are thinking that when we do pranayama, we consume lots of oxygen. No, it is not like that. When you practice pranayama, we consume less oxygen, but the lungs are given exercise, that practice. There is a connection, the birth and death with pranas. Therefore, this pranayama method must be understood seriously and thoroughly, otherwise don't practice. Just have as the knowledge. Okay, this pranayamas are taught in many varieties of way. For general health, you can learn that pranayama, we call it nadi shuddhi. Nadi shuddhi means inhale and exhale. Inhale deeply and exhale deeply. Means you should not make noise, you know. No, just relaxly you can inhale and immediately you can exhale relaxly. You keep doing, your old problems of sinus trouble, headache and blood purification, everything will be nourished. You know, you will be having healthy brain, healthy body, mind and sense complex. Okay, we are moving to the next verse. Apare niyata haraha pranan pranesh juhvati sarve pyete yajna vidaha yajna kshapita kalmashaha. Apare, other people, niyata aharaha. Niyata aharaha means they bring discipline in the food, means eating style. They don't eat whatever they want to eat. So I know a yogi, so that the same yogi whom I said, he has only cow's milk, that too with the same cows. So if that cow dies, so he will have the milk with the calf of that cow. So this is a discipline, bringing discipline with ahara. So this ahara, it plays the vital role. We don't take from anybody else. So only sannyasis and brahmacharis are allowed to take bhiksha. Otherwise you should not, you know, take it freely. This food is the boat or is the post, the karmapala which travels easily. So we can get prasada. See, in our society we have separate. When there is annadana, it is considered as an yajna. So when the food provided in the temple, it is considered as the prasada. So when it is cooked at home, that person who cooks, she becomes annalakshmi. So this food is the main role to play in our life. And that too with annamaya kosha. Vedanta divides this body into five koshas. Annamaya, pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya and anandamaya. This annamaya is considered with food product, the nourished body alone. So body is because of annam and pranas are because of also annam. So food gives the energy. That energy is known as also pranaha. If only you are doing pranayama, you won't be nourished. You need to have a proper food. These people, they bring a pakka discipline with their food. And they don't take from outside, they work for their own bread and butter. And after working for that food, while consuming, they keep, you know, one third for others, one third for temples, and one third they take for themselves. So this is the valued method. They consider akharaha shuddha chitta shuddhihi bhavaniyam. It has to help to get pure mind. Therefore we call annam brahma raso vishnuho bhokta devo maheshwaraha iti sanchintya bhanjanaha annadoshayirna lipyate. So when you see the food, annam brahma, you have to see as the God alone, Ishwara alone. And bhokta, annam brahma, raso vishnu, rasaha means the energy which exists in that food is nothing but Vishnu alone. Bhokta, the ego, that eater of that food is considered as the Maheshwara. This is the attitude we have to set when we see the food. So you become very careful hereafter, you know, with your food. I'm not talking about the varieties of the food. I'm not talking about cooked or raw or fast food, junk food. You avoid fast and junk food. Just have the home-cooked food and that to make it pure. So pure means when we cook, we have to chant mantras. At least a shloka. You ask them to play a record and ask them to cook. Vishnu Sahasranama, Lalita Sahasranama. So these, you know, when while cooking they hear this, the food becomes a pure naivedya prasada alone. So they are very strict with the food. They don't eat for the sake of taste, just they eat for the sake of life to go continue with. See, all these 12 kinds of yajnas have been completed. Sarvepi ete yajna vidaha yajna kshapita kalmashaha. All these yajnas, all these people are called, so yajna vidaha means the number of yajnas, and they all yajna kartaraha yajna kshapita kalmashaha yajnena kshapita kalmashaha. All of them are purified by this yajnas. Purified means they gain the maturity for knowledge to be assimilated. Next words, yajna cheshta amrita bhujaha yanti brahma sanatanam nayam lokotya yajnasya kutonyah kuru sattamah. Now he has completed this 12 yajnas and the bhavanas which we discussed in the last chapter. He brings the same theory here. Before that, let us count this 12 yajnas. First, he began with Brahma Jnana Yajna, Daiva Yajna, Indriya Nigraha Yajna, Vishaya Grahana Yajna, Atma Samyama Yajna, Then he began the next verse, Dravya Yajna, Tapo Yajna, Yoga Yajna, Swadhyaya Yajna and Jnana Yajna. Finally, we saw today Pranayama Yajna, Ahara Niyata Yajna. These 12 varieties of Yajnas are given in all worships, festivals, in all Sanatana Dharma activities. And different branches they follow in different way the same Yajnas. So just you have the knowledge in your mind, all of them are considered Yajnas. The people who become successful, you could see one of these Yajnas will be followed by them. Okay, so Yajna means not only the fire rituals, so body, mind and sense complex can be also made as a Havan Kunda, Homa Kunda. So now, in this verse, verse number 31, he says, one who takes only Yajna Prasada, just he reaches Brahman, he reaches to the absolute goal, he never deviated. Bhatakta nahi hai, nayam lokaha asti, ayajnasya kutaha anya kurusattama. If somebody who is not performing Yajna, for them, this loka also won't provide happiness. It means what? Life has to be endowed with Yajna Karya. Otherwise, you will be deviated. You will be sent back to the Padala Loka. So, when he says Krishna, he is very firm with that. If you want to have the successful life in and out, you have to be endowed with Yajna. No other way. Nanya pantha ayanaya vidyate. The Yajna becomes that much valid part in our life. Okay. Evam bahuvidha yajnyah vitata brahmano mukhe karma jan vidhitan sarvan evam yatva vimokshase. Thus, there are many varieties of yajnas are introduced by our Vedas. All of them born out of karma, that you have to understand clearly. Tan sarvan evam yatva vimokshase. You should know all these yajnas are karma mayam. Karma mayam means they are endowed with karma phala. So when you become aware about it, you can give importance to that Brahma Jnana Yajna. That is the supreme Yajna, he says in the next words. Shreyan Dravyamayan Yajna Jnana Yajna Parantapar Sarvam Karma Khilam Partha Jnane Parisam Apyate. He divides all the Yajnas into two categories, Jnana Yajna and Dravya Yajna. Except Brahma Jnana Yajna, all other Yajnas require some material, require some kind of activity, karmas. Therefore, they are considered as Dravya Yajnas. So, this Shreyan Dravya Mayad Yajnas, this Jnana Yajna is the greater than all other Dravya Yajnas. Sarvam Karma Khilam Partha Jnane Parishamapyate. All these Yajnas are filled with karma. All those karmas are sacrificed. All those karmas, they get absorbed by Jnana Yajna. That is the conclusion that we will continue in from the next episode in detail way. We'll see you. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Now